What are some of the ahadith that mention the blessings of Surah Al-Kahf? There are many ahadith, we'll summarize only two or three because of time. Once it is narrated in Sahih Bukhari, a companion was reciting Surah Al-Kahf. His name is Al-Bara ibn Azim, famous companion. And he noticed his horses becoming agitated. So he looked up and he saw a chandelier basically of light coming down. He saw lights that are many different, like what we call a chandelier. And when he recited, the chandelier of lights would come down. And when it came down, the horses became agitated. When he stopped reciting, the chandelier went up, or the lights went up. So he went and he informed the Prophet ﷺ what is going on. And the Prophet ﷺ said, "Tilka sakina nazalat." This is the sakina. Ibn Hajar says these are the malaika. They're called sakina because wherever the angels go, peace comes. Right? تَنَزَلَ مَلَائِكَةُ الرُّوحِ بِإِذْنَ رَبِّكَ وَرَمِ السَّلَامٌ هِيَ حَتَّى مَطْلَعِ الْفَجْرِ. Wherever there are angels, there is salam and sakina. And so tilka sakina, this is the peace that came down because you're reciting Surah Al-Kahf. They came down to listen to the Qur'an. So Surah Al-Kahf is such a beautiful surah, even the angels wanted to come down to listen to it. We already mentioned that the Prophet ﷺ said, Surah Al-Kahf is of the earliest revelations. إِنَّهُنَّ مِنَ الْعِتَاقِ الْأُوَلِ. These are from the earliest revelations that have been given to me. Why? Because Surah Al-Kahf fortifies you from iman, in your iman. It tells you that no matter whatever is happening, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of you. So Surah Al-Kahf was revealed in the first or second year of the da'wah. Another blessing of Surah Al-Kahf, Abu Darda narrated that our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Whoever memorizes the first 10 verses of Surah Al-Kahf will be saved from the fitna of Dajjal, from the trials of Dajjal. Whoever memorizes the first 10 verses of Surah Al-Kahf will be protected from the fitna of Dajjal." And in another hadith by Nawas ibn Saban, which is a very long hadith, Nawas says, "One day we started talking about the Dajjal, the Sahaba. And we became so scared, we felt he might be in the trees outside the masjid." You know, when you talk about stories, you get a little bit scared. When the Prophet ﷺ saw us, he said, "What is the matter? Masha'nukum?" So they said, "We talked about the Dajjal until we became terrified." So the Prophet ﷺ then, one of the longest ahadith about Dajjal is in Sahih Muslim. He told them all of these details and what is he going to come with and what are his trials. And it's a long hadith. And in it he said, "If Dajjal comes when I am amongst you, then I will be your argumenter or your protector against him. But if he comes when I am not here, then every Muslim will be his own protector. You won't have any figure that you can go to then. فَكُلُّ مُسْلِمٍ حَجِيجُ نَفْسِهِ. Everyone, you will have to basically be your own protector when you argue against Dajjal. So then he said, "So whoever amongst you sees him, فَمَنْ أَدْرَكَهُ مِنْكُمْ, then let him recite the beginning of Surah Al-Kahf." Let him recite the beginning of Surah Al-Kahf. So we learn therefore that the beginning of Surah Al-Kahf, and in the other hadith, the 10 verses of Surah Al-Kahf will protect you from the fitna of Dajjal. Another blessing of Surah Al-Kahf is that our Prophet ﷺ said, "Whoever recites Surah Al-Kahf on a Friday will have a light emanating from him until the next Friday." Reported in Musadrak of Al-Hakim. Reciting Kahf on Friday will give you a light until the next Friday. And similar to this, Abu Sa'id al-Khudri narrated that whoever recites Surah Al-Kahf as it was revealed. As it was revealed, which means recite it properly with tajweed, with khushur. You recite it not just like a cassette tape, you recite it with proper tilawah, which means you do it with khushur. Then he meets Dajjal, that person shall be saved from Dajjal overpowering him. That's the first blessing. The second blessing, the same hadith. And whoever recites Surah Al-Kahf on one Friday shall have a light, in this version it says, coming from him all the way shining to Makkah. And this hadith shows us therefore that this light is so powerful, it's as if it will illuminate all the way to Makkah. And in yet another version, which is slightly weak, and there's no harm in narrating it, it is said that whoever recites Kahf will have all of his minor sins forgiven until the next Friday, from one Friday to the next. So clearly, there's something about reciting Kahf on Friday. Now, why is Surah Al-Kahf linked with protection from Dajjal? What's the deal about protecting from the Dajjal? And by the way, the fitna of Dajjal, it is the worst fitna that mankind has ever seen. Our Prophet ﷺ said, that since Allah has created Adam up until the day of judgment, there is no trial that is more harmful to mankind than Dajjal. There's no fitna that will cause more destruction, wreak more havoc, kill more people, cause more bloodshed than the fitna of Dajjal. Dajjal will come, we learn from our traditions, and he will claim to be a god on earth. And he will be given apparently certain miracles that will fool mankind into thinking this man is a god. He shall be able to stop the water, the rain from flowing. That whoever rejects him, he will perish or die. He will be able to be killed. Whoever believes in Dajjal, Dajjal will snap his fingers and the water will fall. And the plants will flourish and the people will be able to eat. So whoever rejects the Dajjal will be tested and tried. Whoever accepts the Dajjal's claim that he is God will flourish on earth. So he will be tested and tried. Sorry, people will be tested and tried through him like no other fitna. So what has Surah Al-Kahf got to do with this? Well, look at the beginning of Surah Al-Kahf. The very first story set up in the first 10 verses is about those young men who believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the king was trying to kill them. So what happens? They fled seeking Allah's protection. Allah gave them that protection. In the time of Dajjal, Dajjal will be that king. And he will be that person going and killing everybody who believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we need to become like those young men who fled away. And in fact, our Prophet literally said that a time will come when the Dajjal is here, the believers will run to the mountains, they will run to the Jibal, running away from the Dajjal. And this is exactly what these young men did. They fled to the mountains and they sought refuge in caves. And that is exactly what Muslims will do later on in time. Also, one of the trials, one of the biggest trials of Dajjal will be what? That he will be able to control food and water. Allah will give him that power. And so what will you do when you don't have water to drink? When you don't have food to eat? If you believe in Dajjal, you will get that food. And if you don't believe in Dajjal, he will cause the water to stop amongst you. He will cause the earth to go dry. What does Surah Al-Kahf say? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explicitly says, إِنَّا جَاعِلُونَ مَا عَلَى الْأَرْضِ صَعِيدًا جُرُزًا. We are the ones who make what is upon this earth barren and dry. We're the ones who do that. So if you want to be fed, turn to me. Don't turn to the Dajjal. So the beginning of Surah Al-Kahf mentions it is Allah's power to dry up the earth and not the power of Dajjal. And also, we learn here that those who sought refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala paved a way out for them. How perfectly the 10 verses finish. That Allah says in the Quran that when they sought refuge in the cave, they said, رَبَّنَا آتِنَا مِنْ لَدُنْكَ رَحْمَةً وَهَيِّئْ لَنَا مِنْ أَمْرِنَا رَشَدًا. This is exactly where the 10th verse stops. Oh our Lord, bestow your mercy upon us and help us in our affairs. That's exactly where the 10th verse stops. So it's an optimistic verse. Notice here, what is the 11th verse which we're not supposed to recite when we meet the Dajjal? That's the two. We're only supposed to recite 10 verses. What is the 11th verse? The 11th verse is what? Allah saved them by causing them to go to sleep. We don't want to be saved by Dajjal through sleep. That's not how we're going to be saved. The Prophet told us, we will be saved when Isa ibn Maryam comes. Our saving from Dajjal will not be through sleep. So we don't recite the 11th verse. We stop right at the 10th. And the 10th tells us that they made dua to Allah and Allah answered their dua. We're supposed to recite those 10 verses.